were here before. Couldn't look you in the eye. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You float like a butterfly in a beautiful world. I wish I was special. You're so very special. But I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't care if it hurts. I wanna have control. I want a perfect body. I want a perfect soul. I want you to notice when I'm not around. You're so very special. I wish I was special. But I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Ow, 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 ow. She's running out the door. Run out the door. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Whatever makes you happy, whatever you want. You're so very special. I wish I was special. But I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong here. Anyhows, I didn't know it until today, but this lady said, Dennis, you're losing your teeth. And I said, really? Is that true? And anyhows, I said to her, I said, you're only the 2,000 or 3,000 person that's told me that I'm losing my teeth. I knew that years ago I was losing my teeth. I knew that. I really did. But this lady came up to me today when I was shoveling the driveway and said, Dennis, you're losing your teeth. Yes, I am. I am losing my teeth. Does it bother me? No. It doesn't bother me in the least. You can't keep your teeth forever. You know what I mean? I had the Colgate smile when I was 20. And 25 and 35, but when I hit my 40s, I started to lose my teeth. Do I regret it? No, I don't regret anything. I'm aging. I'm getting old. I'll be 54 this February, So for all you people that say, Dennis, you're losing your teeth, are you worried about it? Does it bother you? No, it doesn't bother me in the least. Really, it doesn't. I'm aging. I'm getting old. When you get old, your teeth fall out. Does it bother me? Not one bit. Not one bit. As long as I got some bottom teeth to chew my steak or to chew the chocolate bar or whatever I'm eating, chips or whatever. You can't keep your teeth forever. Look at all the old people that got no teeth. They absolutely got none. But the lady came up to me and said, do you know you're losing your teeth? And I said, yes, I know that. You're about the 3,000th person that told me that. So I think I know I'm losing my teeth. Anyhow, I said, don't worry about my teeth. I said, the rest of my body's all intact from head to toe. I'm not losing my hair, and I'm not losing my body or anything like that. So don't worry about Dennis losing his teeth, because it don't bother me one bit. A lot of people out there that got teeth, that's so insignificant, really it is. I got a buddy of mine, he said, Dennis, do you know I'm losing my hair? And I said, let me take a look. Yeah, you're losing your hair. And I said to him, is that supposed to bother me or something? Or am I supposed to point that out, that you're losing your hair? I said, I couldn't care less if you were bald-headed. Makes no difference to me. Same idea if I look at somebody and they got no teeth. I couldn't care less. Couldn't care less. Anyhow, you can't keep your teeth forever. You can't keep them. They're going to fall out eventually. I never took care of my teeth when I hit my 40s onwards. I just let everything go. But before that, I used to take care of all that stuff and whatnot. But I just gave up there when I hit my 40s. I said, screw it. I ain't got to look good for anybody. I'm not going to try to impress nobody or try to be a big shot. Anyhow, to lose your teeth is not scary. It's not scary. There's some people lose more than their teeth. You know what I mean? There's some people can't walk. They're in wheelchairs. They're way worse off than I ever dreamed of being. There's people out there can't see a thing. They're blind as a bat. Blind as a bat. We got to be thankful we can get out and walk around and get up each day and get outdoors a little bit. So for me to lose my teeth, that's a very small thing. Insignificant. Anyhows, come by my folk art paintings at 27 Canaan, C-A-N-A-A-N Avenue, Apartment B, Kemphill, Yellow Hills, White Trim. I live at 902-365-5044. Give me a call. 902-365-5044. Losing your teeth don't mean a damn thing. I've seen some people that lost all their hair, and I don't point to them and say, you know something? You're losing your hair. Who gives a shit if they go bald or lose their teeth? I couldn't care less. Couldn't care less. The only thing I care about is come by my folk art paintings and abstract art paintings. I live at 27 Canaan, C-A-N-A-A-N Avenue, Apartment B, Kemphill, Yellow Hills, White Trim. You can call me at 902-365-5044. Anyhow, a lot of pretty girls that have nice white teeth, I don't really find that attractive. I really don't. Because they flaunt their teeth too much. All they do is open their mouth and smile and giggle and go, ha 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 ha. And a big Colgate smile comes across their face. That doesn't impress me, none. When I look at a woman, I look at the figure. I don't look at the teeth. The teeth to me are insignificant. Insignificant. It's like when you look at a woman and you look at her hair. Oh, doesn't she have lovely long blonde hair? Doesn't she have lovely, long red hair? Who cares less about the hair of the person? I couldn't care less. And I couldn't care less about the Colgate smile. When I look at a woman, I look at the figure to see if the figure is in check. And if the body doesn't look good, I'm not even interested. I look at the figure first. I don't look at the hair and the teeth. I look at the figure. If the figure is enticing and appealing, that's what you should be interested in, not the woman's hair or teeth or what she spits out of her mouth for talk. What you should be interested is in the figure, if they look good. Because a lot of women do look good. There's a lot of women have nice figures, and the other half don't. It's half and half. Half look enticing, and the other half look discouraging, like you want to walk away from them. Anyhow, when I look at a woman, I don't look at the hair. I don't look at their teeth. So for that lady to come up to me and say, do you know you're losing your teeth? Who cares? I couldn't care less if I lost all my teeth. Makes no difference to me. I'm getting old. I'll be 54 this February. You can't keep all your hair and your teeth and everything. I got all my hair, but I'm losing my teeth. So when I look at a woman, I don't look at their teeth. I don't look at their hair. I look at the figure. And if I like the figure, then I'll be friends with them. If I look at them and I find them not attractive or very discouraging, I don't want nothing to do with them. I look at the figure first. They got to look nice. Some women, their proportions are offbeat. They don't look right at all. Then other women, they look good. They look good. See, everybody thought it was the Colgate smile. When a woman opens up her mouth, if she has nice teeth, everything is gravy and good. That's not true. Teeth are insignificant. They don't mean a damn thing to me. I look at the figure first, and I couldn't care less about the hair or the teeth. It's insignificant. It's not important. It really isn't. Some women don't look good, so you want to stay clear of them. And other women, they look good, you might want to get close to them or get to know them. So, it's all psychology. It's like the old saying goes, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And my eye of the beholder will be different than yours. It won't be the same. Because Colgate smile and nice teeth doesn't mean that that person is a nice person or a good person just because they have good teeth. They might have a Colgate smile and turn out to be meaner than a rattlesnake or meaner than Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Grinch. Beauty is only skin deep. Beauty is only skin deep. So if you look at a woman and she looks pretty and everything looks nice, I've met some pretty women in my life. I've dated them. They were drop-dead gorgeous, but they had nasty tempers, and they had nasty personalities. That's why I say beauty doesn't always top character or the personality part of the body. There's a lot of women that are not really attractive, but they have good personalities, and they're nice people. So don't judge people on hair, teeth. Judge them on their character and their personality first. That's the moral of my story. Anyhow, my time's up. I hope you like that song, Creep, and have a nice day.